And it was the Jayalalitha government which gave permission for the Sterlite factory to be started in Tuticorin. And today the central government has diluted all the norms of environment protection, and that is how industries like Sterlite very easily get their licenses renewed, and that is why they've got their permission for expansion also. The Chief Minister is not ready to meet the people. Where would he meet? Why didn't he meet? He went inside. The working president of the DMK, who is opposition leader, went inside and asked to meet the Chief Minister. Why were they stopped? If they were not stopped, they wouldn't have had to sit in Dharna there. Why didn't the Chief Minister meet him? He was also inside the secretariat. Why didn't he meet him? What excuse does he have?
On the DMK leaders, I mean, they have also alleged that the DMK leaders have constantly violated the section 144, asking the leaders not to go, and the leaders were constantly going into Tuticorin.
I mean, what choice do the other leaders have? Because the Chief Minister or any of the ministers are unwilling to go and meet the people there. They don't want to reach out. So at least the opposition leader and leaders from other parties have to go and meet the people and calm the situation, and people have to be reassured.
Sterlite, they have given a notice that they have closed the operations, but what is to you?
We want it to be permanently closed. It is not closing down the operations or closing, stopping expansion. The expansion has been stopped because of the High Court. And we want the industry to be completely shut down, closed forever.
Have you seen failure of intelligence on the part of the government?
Definitely. The government is blaming that there have been extreme forces which have come into the protest and which has created issues like this. Then it is again the state government's failure, complete failure of intelligence to not know this before.
People and activists on the ground are saying it's a deliberate assault.
In Tamil Nadu, because of the state government's inefficiency, we've had more than 22,000 protests. And the state government has decided that this is the best way to teach people a lesson and to make sure that there are no further protests in Tamil Nadu. They've resorted to this.
So you think the violence is
It is just to intimidate and threaten the people.
So this protest is another continuation.
This protest, all the party leaders have said that the protest will continue, and we are with the people. This is not a protest led by the parties. This is a protest which was initiated by the people, and the parties are supporting them.
But will the DMK leaders also be going to Tuticorin now despite Section 144?
Our leader went, and he was there. He met the people, and many political leaders have gone there, or alliance partners have gone there and met them. Definitely, we will continue to go and meet them because the state government seems to be completely nowhere.
Vedanta has said that they are just waiting for the court and the state government to give them permission. They will start operations again. So let's say the DMK comes to power in the next elections. How will they deal with this?
The DMK will definitely come to power in the next elections, and if the industry, the factory is not shut down by then, we will shut it down.